Winston Churchill once said there is something about the outside of a horse that is good for the inside of a man. That's Blackhorse for Heroes, an equestrian center in Bethany that helps returning veterans with a special program involving people and horses. And here to tell us more about it is Brad Bertella. And the big guy here is?
Ben, this is Gentle Ben.
Hey, Gentle Ben. Oh, he's so gentle too. Hi, how are you doing? Is he doing okay out here with us?
Oh, he's having a good time. Okay. You know, he loves the camera.
He's
a big ham.
Well, we got to have somebody like him to help us out, right? Tell us a little bit about what you offer there. Is this a kind of therapy and guidance program?
Blackhorse for Heroes was started as my extension of my recreation as an Army veteran to other veterans. We didn't want to offer any charge or anything like that. And it started to grow more into, well, maybe we can help some disabled guys. And then it became real awareness of veteran issues, of post-traumatic stress, and then just some guys that may need some guidance. So that's why we say therapy and guidance. We work with the PRRP programs at the VA hospitals. So the guys that are disabled, they come and they get some work with us. But there are guys that are not disabled who don't want therapy, but could use a little help figuring out what it means to be a civilian.
And what a lot of people don't really understand is that we do need to reach out to our veterans after they come home.
Yeah, I think in our society we've kind of forgotten what honor is, and veterans that go out and serve their country feel and experience that sense of honor and then come home, and they're alone. They don't no one else in the society understands that, so there's not that absorption of that appreciation of honor. And we try to bring that to light and try to give these guys an understanding of who they are and where they are. And we try to get our society to say, hey, this is an honorable thing they've done. Let's contribute.
Absolutely. And let's talk more about the program itself. So when they come to the center, what do you do with Wood Ben?
Well, we have opportunities for veterans to privately talk some of their issues, what they're feeling. I try to explain who they are as a veteran, talk a little bit about that, and just give them some real world ideas of what they are and what they're going to be and what they can expect. And then from there, we do some ground school training with the horses, teach them about the theory of the horse and how the horse works and what the horse can expect and how to interact with the horse.
Let's talk about some of that interaction. So how do you connect the veterans with Ben?
Well, ultimately, the class ends with actually working with the horse. Horses work on body language, and we work mostly by verbal. So a returning veteran, especially someone who has some post-traumatic experiences, it's very difficult for them to communicate at home. So by putting them in the program the way we've designed it, we're giving them an opportunity to interact with this animal based upon body language.
You were showing me something really interesting before. Let's show everybody else. And that was, what did you call this?
The scratching?
The scratching.
Yeah, just go ahead.
And you have to scratch really hard, right?
Well, yeah, they're a very large animal. He's 1,800 pounds. But you can very quickly tell that he's liking it with his lips.
He's smacking him?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, this is great.
He wiggles his mustache.
Oh, I love that. This is great. And what else teach vets with this type of horse?
I like to explain that dogs are great therapy animals, mm-hmm. but if you lock your wife and your dog in the trunk for an hour, which one's happy you returned? So there's that loyalty that a dog that doesn't often facilitate that resocialization that a traumatized vet may need. A horse, on the other hand, is a prey animal. You have to earn their trust. And they're not verbal at all. You could talk to a dog and ask the dog to sit and do certain things. The horse, all your responses are through body language. So it cuts through all the issues that a vet might have of trying to communicate. You know, they've gone through so many extraordinary experiences. Coming home is unusual. And being home is unusual. And trying to talk to mom about anything is tough because of what they've been through.
Well, so far, what kind of impact have you seen among the vets you've already helped out?
Within minutes of working with a guy like this, just big smiles. You know, it's overwhelming how powerful it is to put someone in a situation where they feel lost and incomplete, and all of a sudden they feel good again. You know, the other thing is, if they've got these extraordinary experiences and they have nothing to talk about at home, I tell these guys, when you're done with this, you can talk to any girl in any bar about horses, and they're really excited about that.
You know, Brad, it also helps that you yourself is a vet.
Yeah, I served the United States Army, and as I started putting this program together, that sense of honor returned and really drove me to do this. And then as I got more and more involved in it, a lot of self-reflection. I didn't go to Afghanistan. I didn't go to Iraq. I was in a combat unit in the Cold War. So I never considered I would have suffered anything or have any experiences. But as I reflected and designed this program, it turned out that I had a lot more than I was ready to admit. So it helped me a lot. But it also gave me the opportunity to know enough about the trauma to be able to talk about it and understand and help these guys.
Absolutely. Also, you're staffed by other veterans as well.
Dr. Greg Coyle is an Army vet and a good friend of mine. He's had a PhD and he directs our clinical programs. And a lot of other vets volunteer and get in the program. So it gives that sense of been there, done that. A lot of vets are unhappy about where they are in their life. And so they kind of look to vets that have made it to the other side as a mentor. And that's kind of how I feel. That's why it's not really therapy. It's a little bit more mentoring to just say, hey, guys, you know, let me show you how you can work things out.
It's got to be so helpful for them. You also really reach out to veterans who are disabled.
Yeah. One of the nice things about driving with a carriage is I can sit down with you for 5 minutes, talk to you a little about theory, jump in and teach you, and right away you're driving this horse. We have one carriage that has a ramp, and if you're in a wheelchair, we roll you right into the ramp and off you go. So the carriage work gives you a lot of benefits that you wouldn't otherwise get into saddle. The disadvantage is it's expensive and takes a lot of training, both on the horse and the instructor.
And the programs are what, an hour long?
Programs can usually be about 3 hours. What happens, we go through a lot of different steps and a lot of different training, and we don't rush it. Mm-hmm. So the interaction with the animal can take quite a while if you let it. You know, it's not something that you just rush. You enjoy it, you take your time, you get the relationship with the animal, and, you know, how do you rush it?
And Ben makes it really easy, doesn't
he? Yeah, he does.
Look at him. He's so lovable. All right, one thing you do need is funding to keep the program going. You've got a special fundraiser coming up. Tell us about
Saturday, August 25th, we're having a fundraising dinner. It's down at the Sikorsky Memorial Airport. We're transforming a hangar into a ballroom, live music, horses, raffles, a lot of fun. We've done this on our own, Melissa and I. And it's gotten to the point where it's so effective and the VA hospitals are adopting it that we have to continue.
You absolutely do. And we have some information right there on the screen for you. Let's take a look at that. Black Horse for Heroes, first annual fundraising dinner, Saturday, August 25th from 6 to 10 p.m. at the Volvo Aviation Hangar, Sikorsky Memorial Airport in Stratford. The website is there on the screen as well, blackhorsesforheroes.org. It's a great program. Thanks so much for joining us, Brad.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
And stay with us, more Connecticut Style coming right after this.